still kids, but we're so in love, fighting against all odds. I know we'll be alright this time. Darling, just hold my hand, be your girl, you'll be my man, and I see my future. Between my arms, barefoot on the grass, while listening to our favorite song. When I saw you in that dress, looking so beautiful, I don't deserve this. Darling, you look perfect.
Cause all get me all of you. I give you all of me. And you give me all of you. Oh.
When your legs don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you off of your feet, will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheek? Darling, I will be loving you. Baby, my heart could still feel less hard at 23. And I'm thinking about how people fall in love in mysterious ways. Maybe just the touch of a hand. Well, me, I fall. Gone and my memory fades, and the crowds don't remember my name. When my hands don't play the strings the same way, I know you will still love me the same. 'Cause honey, your soul could never grow. Baby, your smile's forever in.
found a love for me. Well, darling, just dive right in and follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. Kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time. Well, darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes you're holding mine. Baby,
dreams. I hope that someday we'll share our home. I found love to carry more than just my secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own. We are still kids, but we're so in love, fighting against all odds. I know we'll be alright this time. Darling, just hold my hand. Be your girl, you'll be my man. And I see my future in your eyes. Well, baby, I'm dancing in the dark with you between my arms, barefoot on the grass, while listening to our favorite song. When I saw you in that dress, looking so beautiful, I don't deserve this. Darling, you look
your smart mouth drawing me in and you kicking me out. You got my head spinning, no kidding, I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride, and I'm so dizzy, don't know what hit me. all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me, I give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose, I'm winning. 'Cause I give you all of me, and you give me all of you. Oh, how many times do I have to tell you? Even when you're crying, you're beautiful too. The world is beating you down. I'm around through every mood. You're my downfall, you're my muse, my worst distraction, my rhythm and blues. I can't stop singing, it's ringing in my head for you. My head. Give your all to me, I'll give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose, I'm winning. 'Cause I give you all of me, and you give me all.
When your legs don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you off of your feet, will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheek? Darling, I will be loving you. Baby, my heart could still fall as hard at 23. And I'm thinking about how people fall in love in mysterious ways. Maybe just the touch of a hand. Well, me, I fall. Kiss me under the light of a thousand stars.
I found a love for me. Well, darling, just dive right in, follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. Kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time. Well, darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes you're holding mine. Baby, between my arms, barefoot on the ground.
kids, but we're so in love, fighting against all odds. I know we'll be alright this time. Darling, just hold my hand, be your girl, you'll be my man, and I see my future in your eyes. Well, baby,
listening to our favorite song. When I saw you in that dress, looking so beautiful, I don't deserve this. Darling, you look perfect tonight.
No, no, no.
Drawing me in and you kicking me out. You've got my head spinning, no kidding. I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride, and I'm so dizzy, don't know what hit me, but I'll be alright. My head, give your all to me, I give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose, I'm winning. 'Cause I give you all of me, and you give me all of you. How many times do I have to tell you? Even when you're crying, you're beautiful too. The world is beating you down. I'm around through every mood. You're my downfall, you're my muse, my worst distraction, my rhythm and blues. I can't stop singing, it's ringing in my head for you. My head.
When your legs don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you off of your feet, will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheek? Darling, I will be loving you. Baby, my heart could still fall less hard at 23. And I'm thinking about how people fall in love in mysterious ways. Maybe just the touch of a hand. Well, me, I fall. Gone and my memory fades, and the crowds don't remember my name. When my hands don't play the strings the same way, I know you will still love me the same. Cause honey, your soul could never grow.
Where we are. be seated. Friends, we're gathered together in the sight of God to witness and bless the joining together of Brian Sawyer, Bonnie Paz, and Christian marriage. The covenant of marriage was established by God who created us for one another. With his presence and power, Jesus graced a wedding in Cana of Galilee. And in his sacrificial love, he gave us the example of the love of husband and wife. Brian and Bonnie come to give themselves to one another in this most holy covenant. So I charge you both as you stand in the presence of God to remember that love and loyalty alone will avail as the foundation of a happy home. If the solemn vows you are about to make are kept faithfully, and if steadfastly you endeavor to do the will of your Father in heaven, your life will be full of joy, and the home you are establishing will abide in peace. No other ties are more tender and no other vows are more sacred than those you now assume. Brian, will you have Bonnie to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her? In sickness and in health and forsaking all others, be faithful to her for as long as you both shall live. If so, will you answer by saying, I will. Bonnie, will you have Brian to be your husband, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him? In sickness and in health and forsaking all others, be faithful to him for as long as you both shall live. If so, we will answer by saying, I will. Who presents this woman to be married to this man? Awesome. Go get her. They have chosen as one of the readings for this day, 1 Corinthians 13, often called the love chapter of Scripture. As I read this, I want to remind you that this is not an idea of some ideal of love that eventually we should attain. This is the call we have to live this way on a regular basis. And it's the call for you all in your marriage. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels but do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so that I can remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all of my possessions to the poor and give over my body to hardship in order to boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others, and it is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered, and it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. And now these three great things remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. And I'm adding a scripture from John 2. This is the wedding in Cana of Galilee. I thought it was appropriate for today. It's about a wedding. Kind of works for y'all. On the third day, there was a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. And Jesus and his disciples had also been invited to the wedding. When the wine ran out, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no more wine." And he replied to her, "Dear woman, what concern is that for you or for me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now standing there were 6 stone water jars for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to them, "Fill these jars with water," and they filled them to the brim. He then said to them, "Now draw some out and take it to the chief steward." So they took it. When the steward tasted the water that had become wine and didn't know where it came from, though those who drew it did know, he called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves the good wine first, and the lesser wine when the guests have had enough. But you have kept the good wine until now." Jesus did this, the first of his signs in Cana of Galilee, and revealed his glory, and his disciples believed in him. Almighty God, bless unto us this reading and the lessons we learn from it. May we hear your word speaking in our hearts. May your word be heard and your love be shown in their household this day and evermore. So speak to in this moment while we wait on thee, and hush our hearts to listen with expectancy. Amen. So brief word for the two of you. Everybody else can listen. You can eavesdrop in, but it's really for the two of you about the scriptures today. The love one seems pretty straightforward. When I asked you about why you want to get married, you both talk about love. We talked about this passage some, but the wedding one I thought was appropriate, not just because it's about a wedding for today. I mean, it's an easy kind of thing, but because of what happens in it. There are three little things that happen in the story that we should keep in mind. It's really our hope for you and what we recognize happening. The first is that there was a problem. And the problem was they ran out of wine. Now, you might think that's easy. Go down to the store and get it, right? That's what we do today. Well, back then, a wedding feast, you think about all the time you put into this today, a wedding feast would last 6 or 7 days, and you had to provide for the entire community. So you can imagine if things ran out, it was not a good sign of things to come. People would judge that. It would look bad for you. You could lose face as a couple. And Jesus steps in to fix what we'll call a problem or a quandary. It's the first time he did that in his ministry here on earth. It's not the first time God did that. The first time God ever stepped in to fix a problem was in creation. When God had created, looked down and said things were good. And then he saw, it says, that man was alone, and it was not good that man was alone. So he created Eve, and then when he saw them together, he says, behold, this is very good. What we see happening here today is a return to that. You see God taking two individuals and bringing them together to make a new creation in a glorious way that we're all excited to be here celebrating with you. It's a wonderful moment we get to see here. And we know that God is coming to fix the idea of loneliness and things in our lives to bring you together that you might have unity and you might have joy and peace together. Secondly, he gave a lot of wine. Math, if you do averages, about 150 gallons, which is a lot of wine. Our prayer for you is that God doesn't just bless you with grace and with love for each other, but it's in such abundance and quantity that it spills over out of your own marriage, the unit you create together, that all of those who know you and love you are blessed by your presence, that when people look at you, they say, that's the kind of marriage we want to have. Because your love you have for each other becomes a love that touches other lives. And we know that God will do that. And lastly, there's the quality. Not just the quantity, but he gives the very best. What we celebrate today is the very best we have on this earth that we can give to each other. And I pray for you, like wine in the story, that the love and the grace and the faith and hope you share together this day will become richer and become more valuable to you, like a wine that's put down on a rack somewhere in a basement, will become more wonderful and more lovely and more celebrated as the years go on, so that this day, as beautiful as it is, will be a wonderful day, but that the best days are yet to come. That's our prayer for you today. And it's a prayer that we ask in Christ's name. And we pray that God's with us. Because as a little girl in Sunday school said, when asked what the story meant, she said the easiest answer in the world, like in second grade, if you're going to have a wedding, it's good to have Jesus there. And it is. And he's with us. And he'll remain with you now and always. And for that, we give him grace and praise and thanksgiving. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I wasn't asking you to turn and face each other and hold hands, but you couldn't wait for that because you just had to hold hands. So I get that. It's good. So if you will repeat after me. In the name of God, I, Brian, take you, Bonnie, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part. This is my solemn vow. Bonnie, you're after me. In the name of God, I, Bonnie, take you, Brian, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until death us do part. This is my solemn vow. May I have the rings? Dear friends, these rings are an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to all the uniting of Brian and Bonnie together in holy marriage. Almighty God, bless the giving of these rings and those who wear them, that they may live in your peace and continue in your favor through all the days of their life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Bonnie, I give you this ring as a sign of my vow, and with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Brian, I give you this ring as a sign of my vow, and with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Bonnie and Brian, you've declared your consent and vows before God and this congregation. May the Lord confirm your covenant and fill you both with grace to keep it. Now that Bonnie and Brian have given themselves to each other with the joining of hands and the giving and the receiving of rings, I announce to you that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have so consecrated the covenant of Christian marriage that in it is represented the covenant between Christ and his church. Send therefore your blessing upon Bonnie and upon Brian, that they may surely keep their marriage covenant, and so grow in love and godliness together, that their home may be a haven and blessing of peace for those that know them and those who will come to know them in the years to come, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. They have decided the first thing they would like to do as an act as a married couple is participate in Holy Communion. So just a word on how we do that here in our congregation, in our denomination. This is not a Lutheran table, and it's not Hope's table. This is the Lord's table of grace. If you commune in whatever background you're from, you're welcome to commune at this table. We will do it by intinction, where a piece of the host we hand it to you that you can then dip in the cup. If you need gluten-free, if you tell me that when you come up, we have a separate cup for that, and we can do that as well. Why don't you all step off over here? You can hold hands and, you know, get close to each other like you like each other. It's okay. You can do that. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth. You formed us in your image. You made us for one another. And you gave us the gift of marriage that we might fulfill each other. And so are there people on earth and all the company of heaven. We praise your name and we join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church. You delivered us from slavery to sin and death and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit, from which flows the covenant of love of husband and wife. On the night which he gave himself for us, our Lord first took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, for this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after the supper, he took the cup, And when he had given thanks, he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Pour out your Holy Spirit upon us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By the same Spirit, bless Bonnie and Brian, that their love for each other may reflect the love of Christ for us and grow from strength to strength as they faithfully serve you and one another in this world. Defend them from all evil. Lead them into all peace. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts, a mantle upon their shoulders, a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, in their sleeping and their waking, in their joys and their sorrows, in their lives and in their deaths. And finally, by your grace, bring them and all of us to that table where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. Through Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And we seal this prayer with the prayer that our Lord taught us as we say together, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come and thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen." Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Come to the feast that is prepared for you. This is the Lord's table of grace, and all of God's people are welcome. I'll begin by serving the wedding party up front, and then we'll move from the front of the church back. Just come as you feel led, and when everyone has been served, we will continue with the service. There are several traditions through the years that have sprung up to celebrate not only the unity of husband and wife, but also the families. Perhaps the most time-honored and well-known of those is the unity candle. You'll note as the families came forward earlier and lit the two candles that represent the family, and Bonnie and Brian are going to come now to use those to light the unity candle, which represents the two families and their lives becoming one.
Two hearts can come together and love can last forever. But now that I have found you, I believe that a miracle has come. When God sends a perfect one, now gone are all my questions about why, and I've never been so sure of anything in my life. Oh, I wonder what God was thinking when he created you. I wonder if he knew everything I would need, because he made all my dreams come true. When God made you, he must have been thinking about me.
Ooh. I promise that wherever you may go, wherever life may lead you, with all my heart I'll be there too. And from this moment on, I won't.
I have just one more word to say to you, because I know you're ready to kiss her. I'm ready for a while. May God the Eternal keep you both in love with each other, so that the peace of Christ may abide in your home. Go to serve one another, and God, and your neighbors, in all that you do. And now it's my very great privilege to introduce for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Brian Sawyer. Brian, you may kiss your bride.